Hello everyone, this is our next lecture on the chapter descriptive statistics and our topic is measure of central tendency. Already we saw three type of measure of central tendency. First one is arithmetic mean, which is denoted by x bar and is defined as it is a ratio of sum of observation to the total number of observation. Then we saw median. So median is the middlemost observation or the series or the observation which divide the series into two equal parts is known as the median. Then we saw mode. Mode is the observation with maximum frequency or the most repeated observation is known as mode. Then we saw calculation of mode for different type of data. So for individual observation, the value which occurs maximum number of times, then it is the mode of the distribution. For discrete frequency distribution, the observation with highest frequency is the mode of the distribution. Means if single observation along with frequencies are given, then mode is the observation with highest frequency. For continuous frequency distribution, means data is of the type class intervals along with frequencies are given. So for in this type of data, firstly we have to locate our modal, premodal and postmodal classes. After locating this, the formula for mode is equal to L plus FM minus F1 divided by 2FM minus F1 minus F2 into H, where L is lower limit or lower boundary of the modal class. FM is a frequency of the modal class. F1 is a premodal frequency and F2 is a postmodal frequency. H is a class width. Then we saw if there is single observation with maximum frequency, then the distribution is known as unimodal distribution. If there are two values which occur with maximum and equal frequency, then the distribution is bimodal. And if there are more than two values of mode, then the distribution is known as a multimodal distribution. Means mode can be unimodal, bimodal and multimodal. Then we saw how to calculate missing frequencies if the value of mode is given. And then how to determine mode graphically. By using the histogram, we can determine mode. Now our next topic is merits and demerits of mode. First we will see what are the merits. So first merit is mode is easy to calculate and understand. In some cases mode can be located just by inspection. So it is very easy to calculate because as the definition, mode is the value which has the maximum frequency and we can just locate the maximum frequency just observing the example. So mode is very easy to calculate. Next one is mode is not affected by extreme values in the data. Next merit is mode can be determined in open end distributions. So for open end classes we can determine mode. It can be used for qualitative type of data. As the drawback of arithmetic mean is it cannot be used for the qualitative type of data. So this drawback is overcome in mode, that is it is a used for qualitative type of data. The value of mode can be determined graphically, means by using the histogram we can locate mode by using the graphical method. Next one is now demerits of mode. First demerit is the value of mode is not based on the all observation of the data, because for calculation of mode we just consider the modal class, premodal class and postmodal class, means other classes are not considered. So the value of mode is not based on the all the observation. Next demerit is mode is not rigidly defined. It is not rigidly defined. Next one is it is indeterminate if the maximum frequency occurs either in the very beginning or at the end of the distribution. Means suppose we just understand this demerit by using the example. Suppose our model class is, this is our model class. So in this case, we cannot define the pre-model class. Pre-model class means the class just before the model class. So here is no class just before the model class. So we cannot define the our pre-model class. Or suppose this is our model class, means last class is our model class. Suppose it has the maximum frequency. Suppose the frequency of this class is 40. So this is our model class. So in this case, we cannot define the post-model class, means the class just after the model class. So in that case, we cannot calculate the mode of that distribution. This is the drawback of the mode, means we cannot calculate mode if the model class is at the beginning or if it is at the end of the example. Next demerit is, it is not suitable for further mathematical treatment. For example, using modal values and size of two or more groups, we cannot find mode of the combined group. So mode of the combined group cannot be calculated. So it is a drawback of mode. Next is empirical relationship among mean, median and mode. In case of symmetric distribution, mean, median and mode are coincide. If they do not coincide, then the distribution is asymmetric or skewed. These two terms, asymmetric or skewed, we'll study in our next chapter deeply. So usually for asymmetric distribution, median lies in between mean and mode, and there exists an important relationship between them given by Karl Pearson. Means in any asymmetric distribution, suppose this is a diagrammatic representation of any distribution, the value of median, that is the median is the value which divides the distribution into, which divide distribution or series into two equal parts. So it is always in between mean and mode, means this first value is of mean, this is median, and the last one is mode. Means for any asymmetric distribution, median lies in between mean and mode, and their relationship is given by the scientist Karl Pearson, and this relationship is known as empirical relationship among mean, median and mode. And it is mean minus mode is equal to 3 times mean minus median. So this relationship is useful to find the third measure of central tendency if we know the other two. Means for any example, if we have given the value of mean and mode and the question is calculate median, so we can calculate median by using this empirical relation. So in some situation, mode is indeterminate if the modal class is at the extreme of the distribution. Means if the first class interval is the modal class or the last class interval is the modal class. So in that case, we cannot define the mode. So to overcome this difficulty in computing mode, the empirical relationship is used. So empirical relationship is mean minus mode is equal to 3 times mean minus median. For example, in a moderately skewed distribution, mean is equal to 100, median is equal to 106, find out the value of mode. So the values of mean and median are given. We have to find the value of mode. So first we will write the given. So for the given example, mean is equal to 100 and median is equal to 106. So mean and median are given. We have to calculate mode. So we can calculate mode by using the empirical relation. And the empirical relation is mean minus mode is equal to 3 times mean minus median. Just substitute the value of mean and median. So mean is 100, mode is, we have to calculate the mode, 3 into 100 minus 106. 100 minus mode is equal to 3 into 100 minus 106 is minus 6. So 100 minus mode is equal to 3 into minus 6, that is minus 18. Just shift this 18 to the LHS. So 100 plus 18 is equal to mod. Therefore, mod is equal to 118. So in this way, if any two measure of central tendencies are given, either mean median or median mode or mean mode are given, then we can calculate the third measure of central tendency by using the empirical relation, that is mean minus mode is equal to 3 times mean minus median. Next topic is partition values. Like median, there are other measures which are positional measure in the series. They are called partition values and they divide the series into two equal parts. Means median divides the series into the two equal parts. Like this, partition values divide the series into the equal parts. Suppose we want to divide the series into four equal parts, then we use the quartiles. So quartiles divide the series into four equal parts. So there are three quartiles, that is Q1, Q2 and Q3. The definition of quartile is the observations Q1, Q2, Q3 which divides the total number of observation into four equal parts. Quartiles, there are three quartiles and they divide the series or observation into four equal parts are called as a quartiles. There are three quartiles which divides the series into four equal parts. The first quartile is known as lower quartile and it is denoted by Q1. So first quartile is called as first quartile or lower quartile and it is denoted by Q1. Second quartile is known as second quartile or median. Means second quartile is also known as the median and it is denoted by Q2. So this is your question of MCQ. Q2 is also known as dash dash. So Q2 is also known as median. And third quartile, and it is also known as upper quartile and it is denoted by Q3. And the relationship between Q1, Q2 and Q3 is Q1 is less than equal to Q2, Q2 is less than equal to Q3. So the series which divides the observation which divides the series into four equal parts are known as the quartiles. There are three quartiles. Q1, that is first quartile or lower quartile, Q2 second quartile or median, and Q3 upper quartile or third quartile. These are the three quartiles. Diagrammatically, quartiles are represent like this. Suppose this is a graph. So this lower quartile is known as Q1. Middlemost observation means median is known as Q2. And last one is known as Q3. So Q1, Q2, Q3. These are the three quartiles which divides the data or series into four equal parts. Means this is the first part, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. And frequency of each part is 25%. 25% means equal frequency. The quartiles divide the series into four equal parts. Means frequency of all the observation means all the part is same, that is 25%. And this is the median, means lower part of the median has the frequency 50% and upper part has the frequency 50%. So this is the value of median. So the definition of quartile is the observation Q1, Q2, Q3 which divides the total number of observation into four equal parts are called as the quartiles. Next topic is calculation of quartiles. So as we know, we can calculate quartiles for three type of data. First one is for individual observation. So for individual observation, there are two ways we can calculate the quartiles for individual observation. It depend on the value of n. If n is n may be odd or n may be even. So our first step is arrange the data either in increasing order or in decreasing order of magnitude. Means firstly we have to arrange the data in increasing or decreasing order. Next step is we have to check the value of n. If n is odd, then quartiles can be calculated by using the formulas. For the first quartile, these formulas for n if n is odd, that is the value of n is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, etc. So first quartile or lower quartile Q1 is equal to, it is the value of n plus 1 by 4th observation. It is not n plus 1 by 4th observation. It is the value of n plus 1 by 4th observation. Second quartile Q2 or median is equal to value of n plus 1 by 2th observation. This is same formula as of median. Median, it is the value of n plus 1 by 2th observation. And for third quartile or upper quartile, Q3 is value of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th observation. For example, following are the temperature record in a certain city observed in a certain week. 35, 38, 40, 39, 35, 36, 37. Obtain the three quartiles. Means we have to obtain all three quartiles. That is Q1, Q2 and Q3. So data is of individual type of data. So our first step is we have to arrange the data either in increasing order or in decreasing order. So we arrange the data in increasing order. Means from smallest observation to the largest observation. So smallest observation is 35 and largest observation is 40. So in this way we can arrange the data in increasing order. Since n is 7, that is odd number, means number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So n is odd. So for the odd number of observation, the formula of Q1, it is value of n plus 1 by 4th observation. That is Q1 is equal to value of, here n is equal to 7. Just substitute the value of n. 7 plus 1 by 4th observation. That is Q1 is equal to 7 plus 1, it is 8. And 8 divided by 4, it is 2. That is value of second observation. Q1 is not 2. It is the value of second observation. So from this series, the second observation is 35. So the value of Q1 is equal to 35. Now Q2. Q2 means formula is same as of median. That is value of n plus 1 by 2th observation. That is Q2 is equal to n is 7. So value of 7 plus 1 by 2th observation. 7 plus 1 is also 8. 8 divided by 2 is 4. So it is the value of 4th observation. And from the series, 4th observation is 37. So the value of Q2 is 37. Similarly, Q3 is, the formula for Q3 is, it is the value of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th observation. So just substitute the value of n. So it is value of 3 into 7 plus 1 by 4th observation. 7 plus 1 is 8. 8 into 3 divided by 4. So 8 into 3 is 24. And 24 divided by 4, it is 6. So Q3 is the value of 6th observation. Q3 is not 6. It is the value of 6th observation. So 6th observation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 6th observation is 39. Therefore, the value of Q3 is 39. In this way, if n is odd, we can calculate the value of Q1, Q2 and Q3, that is lower quartile, median and upper quartile. Next example. The monthly salaries of 10 employees recruited in a firm are rupees 2500, 2780, 2820, 2850, 2680, 2750, 2575, 3000, 2725, 2790, find the quartiles. Here we have to find the quartiles, that is Q1, Q2 and Q3, lower quartile, median and upper quartile. So our first step is we have to arrange the data in increasing order. So increasing order means smallest observation to the largest observation. Here smallest observation is 2500 and largest observation is 3000. So arrange the data in increasing order, or in decreasing order, choice is yours. Here we arrange the data in increasing order. Now next step is find the value of n. N means number of observations. So here number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So number of observations are 10. So n is even. So the formula for Q1, if n is even, is value of n plus 1 by 4th observation. Same formula, value of n plus 1 by 4th observation. So it is value of 10 plus 1 by 4. 10 plus 1 is 11 by 4th observation. That is the value of 11 by 4th observation. Since the value 11 by 4 is in the fraction, so we can write 11 by 4 as 2 into 3 by 4. 2 into 3 by 4 is same as 11 by 4. 11 by 4 can be written as 2 into 3 by 4, which is equals to 11 by 4, because 4 into 2 is 8 and 8 plus 3 is 11, that is 11 by 4. So we can write Q1 11 by 4 as 2 into 3 by 4, because 11 by 4, the value of 11 by 4 is in the fraction, and which is, we cannot find that number in this series. So we can convert 11 by 4 into 2 into 3 by 4. So Q1 is equal to the value of second observation, means these two. The value of second observation plus 3 by 4th into third observation minus second observation. This is the formula for even number of observations. So it is the value of second observation plus this 3 by 4 into, we have to take the next observation. Therefore next observation is third observation minus second observation. Therefore Q1 is equal to, the value of second observation is 2575 plus 3 by 4 into third observation minus second observation. Third observation is 2680 minus 2575. So it is 78.75, and the value of Q1 is 2653.75. Means the formula for Q1, Q2 and Q3 is same, but only difference is here the value, as the value came in fraction, so we can convert it into the, in this form like this, and the formula is this. Now for Q2, the formula is value of n plus 1 by 2th observation. Here n is 10, so 10 plus 1 is 11, 11 by 2th observation. So 11 by 2 can be written as 5 into 1 by 2. So the formula for Q2 is the value of 5th observation plus 1 by 2, 6th observation minus 5th observation. So Q2 is, the value of 5th observation is, the value of 5th observation is 2750 and 6th observation is 2780. So 2750 and 2780, the values are substituted. Therefore Q2 is equal to, after calculating all these, Q2 is equal to 2765. Similarly, Q3 is equal to value of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th observation. That is the value of 3 into n is 10. 10 plus 1 by 4th observation. 10 plus 1 is 11. 11 into 3 is 33. So it is the value of 33 by 4th observation. So value of 33 by 4 can be written as 8 into 1 by 4. So it is the value of 8th observation plus 1 by 4, 9th observation minus 8th observation. So it is 2820
plus 1/4 2850 minus 2820. So the answer of Q3 is 2827.5. In this way, we can calculate lower quartile, median and upper quartile for if the observations are even or number of observations are even. So in today's lecture, we saw merits and demerits of mode, empirical relationship among mean, median and mode, that is mean minus mode is equal to 3 times mean minus median. Then partition values, or first partition value is quartile. There are 3 quartiles, Q1, Q2 and Q3. And definition is the observations Q1, Q2, Q3, which divides the total number of observation into 4 equal parts are called as a quartiles. So this is a diagrammatic representation of quartiles. There are 3 quartiles which divide the data or series into 4 equal parts. Then we saw calculation of quartiles for individual observation, for if number of observations are odd and if number of observations are even. Now we'll continue in next lecture with our next topic. Thank you.